Hello, hello, hello. Welcome back to Hunter Tuned. Today, we're just going to do one of them vloggy things. And yeah, we're heading to the junkyard right now because, I've taken like a week off because of the holidays and stuff, and I've just kind of been, screwing off, as they say. I haven't really been working a whole lot, but I got to get back to work because I'm pretty behind on orders, and I have no injectors, so I got to go to the junkyard and go get some. But you know, as you see, the weather's—it's perfect outside. I mean, it's pretty nice. And I have had some time off. I should say I haven't really had a ton of time off because I've been actually using this truck to snowplow. I think I have like 10 or 12 accounts now. So I was just kind of running around. You know, we had some snow over the last couple weeks, and I've just been snowplowing with this thing because I told myself I'm not going to keep this plow truck unless it pays for itself, because I want it for using it to go ice racing to make our own racetracks, hopefully, which will happen soon. But I didn't want to justify the cost of having the truck if it wasn't at least going to pay for itself. So, yeah, we're about a third of the way paying this thing off already, so pretty sweet. All right, so I just froze my you-know-what off at the junkyard. It's not super cold out, but when you're leaning over trucks with a fucking foot of snow on them, and you gotta take your gloves off all the time to, get the clips off the injectors, and then, you know, whatever, your hands go numb after about two sets of injectors. I started not feeling my hands anymore. But anyways, we got a load of injectors here. Hopefully I can fill the orders that I got over the weekend and get those shipped out right away. But I am running back to my house now to just grab a bite to eat before I go to the shop. And I'll probably grab the Talon and take the Talon out to the shop and just, you know, test on it a little bit, as Vice Grip Garage would say. I drove it around last night, and it runs pretty good. Also, my plow truck, the ABS just freaking kicks on. Just because. No reason. It just likes to turn on and not let you stop. So I'll probably yank the fuse on this thing so it doesn't have any ABS, so I can actually stop. And then hopefully after I get all these injector orders filled, I'll be able to come home and take the snowmobiles out. We'll see. Well, now that a guy went home and had some lunch, changed my whole outfit so it doesn't smell like gas. That's another thing that sucks about going to the junkyard pulling injectors all the time, is your clothes just reek like fuel and gas, and you know, under your fingernails and stuff, it'll just stay with you all day. But yeah, I mean, this thing runs really good. I'm actually driving it on my way out to the shop right now, making a pit stop in Mexico here. Make sure we turn the overdrive off. And yeah, the wideband doesn't really work. The whole way here, it was pegged out all the way lean, but the thing runs fine. And when you get into it, it's got power. It's not like it's 18-0 air fuel, because it wouldn't have as much power as it does. But I mean, she rips pretty good. I mean, it's pretty fun actually. Makes like 20 pounds of boost. But the turbo is definitely a little bit wallowed out. It's not happy at all. But I'm really happy with this car. I still don't know why the engine light is on, but for the most part, I like it. Runs good. Just drove her all the way out to the shop, no issues. From my understanding is this thing's gotta be tuned fairly well. The only reason it wasn't really running right is because the intercooler pipe had a big hole in it, so I fixed it, and now it's been awesome. Heard I haven't been out to the shop in a couple days. And I'm thinking to myself, oh my god, why do I have my shop? I haven't been there in 3 days. Do I even need a shop? 3 days it's been. Hunter, get your fucking head straight. We got a white EG hatch here that we're going to be working on in the next day or so. Yeah, pretty happy with this thing so far. I had to stop at the old Walmart, get me some envelopes for ECU that I'm sending out. All the envelopes that I have are too small, so I had to go get some bigger ones. Got some license plates on this thing. Milwaukee Bucks. I think those plates look really cool, especially on this car. It looks nice. Let's go get something done, I suppose. Add to my pile of envelopes. Guy must have had a cold snack out here the other day. Turn the heater on. I have a little electric heater in my office area, and then out in the shop I have a big heater, but I turn it off when I'm not here, because if I'm not here, it doesn't really need to be 60 degrees or whatever. And if I let the shop sit for, you know, I think I haven't been out here in like 3 or 4 days, it only got down to about 40 degrees in here. This building's actually pretty well insulated, so it doesn't really lose heat that bad. A guy also got the motor in the Mustang last time I was out here. Yeah, everything fit really good. I put the transmission on, and the thing is I got to shim the torque converter to the flex plate, and I don't know if I should use washers or if I should use something else, but when the converter goes onto the flex plate on that engine, it goes too far. Like, it comes too far out of the pump to hit the flywheel, so I think I have to put a spacer between the flywheel and the converter, or some washers or something, so it doesn't come out of the pump as far. But anyways, I'm gonna get to filling my orders here, and then we'll pick up after that. Probably not gonna have enough time to go snowmobiling today, but at least I can do one of the other things on my list. I've been having my girlfriend actually gave me a little notebook, and I've been trying to write down like every day. Like I've done it for 3 days now. Started Saturday, just wrote down all the stuff I wanted to get done on Saturday, and I checked them off as I did them. Sunday, did the same thing. I only had one thing yesterday that I did not get accomplished, and that was go plowing on the ice. It's been like a thing I wanted to do for the last couple weeks, and I haven't done it. But I got all my stuff done Saturday and Sunday, and today so far, it's looking really promising. I just gotta get my orders done, and then we'll do some other things. But look, writing down the tasks that I have to do when I start my day seems to help me a lot, because a guy gets so scatterbrained, and I keep saying a guy, I've been watching Vice Grip Garage way too much, and I'm starting to talk like him, but I really like the way he talks, and I like, yeah, whatever. You guys gotta go check out Vice Grip Garage. Anyways, I just get so scatterbrained and so just jumbled in my head that I get overwhelmed, and then I get depressed, and I just go hide in a corner all day instead of doing anything. So one thing at a time is really what I got to focus on, and just write down the things, and when you write it down on paper, it doesn't seem as bad to go tackle at least the first thing. And once you start doing the first thing, it's a lot easier to move on to the second, the third, the fourth, the fifth thing for that day. It's just a lot easier to do it that way. Especially with me, it's a lot harder because obviously I don't have like a normal 9-to-5 job where I can just be like, yeah, I go to work from 9-to-5, and then I come home and I can do my stuff that I want to do. But for me, it's like I got to get up and do this stuff. I have to like make my own work and make my own schedule. So it's a little bit tough, and I've been battling with it for a while. And I apologize to anybody that I have blown off this year, not messaged back. It's just been really tough with me organizing my work and life schedule, and that's one of my goals for 2021, is I want to just have a better work-life balance instead of all work or all life, because that's what I've been doing a lot. I feel like if I wanted to do take time off of work, I would take all the time off work and I wouldn't do any work. And then when I would work, I would just work so hard all the time and not have any time for myself or life or family or anything. So I want to have a better balance of that. And I think a good start is to have that notebook, and I'm going to just start jotting down all the things I want to do. Like for example, today I got up, I ate, went to the junkyard, I got those injectors. Then I came home because I was initially going to go straight from the shop to, or straight from the junkyard to my shop to fill my orders. And then I was going to rush home, change the oil on the snowmobile, and then go snowmobiling before it got dark outside, and then come home and do other things. I don't know exactly what, but I know, like, me and my girlfriend always watch basketball games together, so like that's something I want to do tonight with her. So that's another thing. It doesn't need to be on my list, but it's just something that I want to have my work done by the time I go home, and then I can just kind of relax for the rest of the night and edit video and stuff like that. So I'm just trying to, like I said, try to find a better work-life balance of scheduling. Another thing too with like dyno tuning, especially like in the springtime and summertime when I have a ton of messages of people wanting to get dyno tuned, I feel like this year I'm going to schedule certain days of the week where I dyno tune. And I'm not going to just, like, all year this year, I would get messages from people be like, hey, can you tune my car tomorrow? Or can you tune my car in 3 days? And I'd be like, sure, yeah, sure. And then, like, the night, I would set an alarm on my phone and be like, oh, shit, I got to tune this guy's car. And then when the day would come, I'd be like, shit, I have all this other stuff that I plan to do because I, like, forgot about it or I didn't schedule it or whatever. But I want to start, like I said, just do, like, this calendar is really old, but I want to do like maybe, you know, Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday for dyno tuning, or Monday, Tuesday, Saturday, or Monday, Wednesday, Saturday. I don't know, something like that. Monday, Wednesday, Sunday, Sunday, Tuesday, Thursday. I don't know. It just sucks because when you're trying to work around somebody else's schedule too, like a lot of people that get dyno tuned are like, oh, well, I work these days and I have this day free. Can you tune me on that day? That was like a thing that came up a lot this year. And I would always just cater to their schedule, which in turn really screwed my schedule. But I did it anyway. Like I said, I think I want to just stick to maybe start doing videos. Like, you know, obviously I don't have a whole ton of dyno tuning right now that I'm doing, but maybe just stick to like Monday, Tuesday, Saturday, or whatever, whatever days I end up picking. Stick to those days for doing dyno tuning. And all the other days, I'm just going to focus on filling my website orders and, you know, maybe do some of my own stuff or whatever. But, yeah. Yeah. Like I said, trying to find a better balance just because, yeah, I don't know. I've been screwed up a lot this year, so it's been tough. But I appreciate everybody that has bared with me and can see through the struggles and just, you know, we can get past it kind of thing. So thank you to everybody that has been sticking around and is a believer in the Hunter Tuned. Got my D-Max in here. It took a nap for the last couple days. Usually I drive this truck every single day, but I took my plow truck home because it's been snowing and I've been doing a lot of snow plowing like I was talking about earlier. Got the Cavalier engine all ready to go to the machine shop. This is another thing I got to write down on my list, is I got to take this engine to the machine shop so we can wash it and maybe put bearings in it and check out the crank, make sure it's all good. I have a set of heads there at the machine shop right now that I have to pick up. It's just a lot of stuff that I have to get written down and, you know, just have set up and whatever. I have to pull the dash out of the Mustang like this week so I can get it over to do the roll cage. That's another thing I gotta write down on my list. I have to rip the dash out of the Mustang. I have to get this car on the hoist because it's been here for a little while. This is a customer's car and I haven't really touched it. He said I have pretty much the whole winter with it, but I do need to get a start on it. So this is another thing I have to write down on my list, is I have to get this thing on the hoist and make a parts list to send over to the guy so he can order the parts, or I can order the parts, or he can send me money to order the parts. What have you. So we have to make a list of parts for this thing. I got to organize out here a little bit better because I have a mess from building my L33. Just kind of chilling out here. I want
want to make a video on the ICT billet products that they had sold me, just because these guys are awesome. I have a ton of stuff from Holley I want to go over as well. Those are another more things I want to put on my list and film. I want to clean up some of my parts that I have over here and list some more stuff for sale so there's not as much clutter in the shop. I have a ton of stuff upstairs yet that I want to clean out. Just a lot of stuff that I'm not using whatsoever. I want to, you know, maybe come out here for a couple hours and just post some of these parts for sale because I'm not using them, and I'd rather get cash for the stuff instead of having it sit around. So that's another thing that I want to do. Sorry for babbling. I may include all that stuff, I may not, but it's just stuff that I'm going to use for myself. While I'm editing, I'm going to be writing all that stuff down on a notebook. Maybe I should get one of them notebooks that like you can put in your pocket so I can break it out and look at it and then write something down if I think of something. I think that'd be a good idea too. Also, another thing for 2021 that I want to, or another thing I want to write down on my list is I want to make a video kind of like what Ryan with A21 Bravo did, with like a flashback of what all happened during 2020 and you know, some of the projects that we did and stuff like that. Maybe do like a live stream style video, or just like a video with me sitting at my computer kind of scrolling through my Facebook pictures and just going back and looking back at the accomplishments we did this year and stuff like that. I think that'd be a really cool idea to do for a video. So we might do that as well. I really should write that down because I think it'd be a great idea for the channel. I just thought of something I forgot to do already on my way out to the shop. I was supposed to go and deposit money into my girlfriend's bank account for her. I forgot to do that. It's just, yeah, it's an everyday occurrence because I'm really shitty at keeping this stuff straight and staying organized and not forgetting stuff, but it happens every day. Well, I just finished up with all my orders, and it's now 4:30, so it's a little bit too late to go snowmobiling, I think, which sucks. I wanted to get out today, but oh well, I'll try to get out tomorrow. But I got all my orders done. I got like 10 of them here that I had packaged up. I'm not going to show the addresses or nothing, but yeah, so I only have, I think, one set of Bosch 2200s left, which is awesome because I didn't think they would sell that good, but honestly, they're awesome injector guys, and They work awesome. They idle great. They're just awesome. So I'm honestly going to take a lot of the money from what I got here for selling all this stuff, and I'm going to actually re-up the Bosch 2200s and keep them in stock for you guys. So that's super cool. Got a ton of those going out. Regular decaps and flexes all going out. I'm probably freaking out of stock again of the stuff, but I don't know. If you guys have any of the regular injectors for sale, or you want to sell them or throw them my way, it's greatly appreciated anytime. Normal style truck injectors or flex injectors, I'm always in need of them. I can't ever seem to keep up with the demand, but nonetheless, very blessed for the people that support me and everything like that. It's funny though, because I buy all this merchandise, like the lanyards, my hats, stickers, windshield banners, etc. And I sell maybe one piece of merchandise for every 10 sets of injectors I sell. It's funny because I have 10 orders here. They're all injectors besides one. One of them is a lanyard and a sticker. So it's funny how that works. But yeah, anyways, go get some merch one of these days, guys. Let me know if you want me to continue to stock the merchandise. Everybody wants me to get t-shirts, but every time I buy like hats and lanyards and stuff, they don't sell. So I don't know. Let me know. Let me know what you think on that. Probably gonna leave the D-Max here overnight. Yeah, hopefully get out here tomorrow afternoon or so, because I promised the girlfriend we go snowmobiling, so we're gonna go snowmobiling tomorrow in the morning or something, and then maybe afternoon I come out here, get the Mustang moved out of the way, maybe rip the dash out of it, and then get that Civic that's outside. The Civic actually got dropped off last night because the guy bought it, and on his way home from buying the car, the wheel fell off. So he wants me to look at it and fix it for him, and he broke down like 5 minutes from my shop, so I said, sure, drop it off. And he told me that I got till Saturday with that thing, so I have all week to fix it. But nonetheless, I don't like putting stuff off, so I'm gonna try to get that to that tomorrow night or Wednesday at the latest. And then, hopefully get home and change the oil on my sled and get them ready for going riding tomorrow. And then I wanted to take this engine over to the machine shop, but man, because this is the engine for the Cavalier, which I have everything for, and I want to get that finished and done and make videos building it and whatever, but I want to get them done soon. Like, I want to get all these projects done before the track opens, which is 12 weeks. The racetrack opens in 12 weeks. I feel like this winter is flying by. Like, time just seems to be flying so much faster as you get older. It's crazy. Like, yeah, I was like dreading winter coming because it takes so long. Winter is like 10 months in Wisconsin, but it's really not. Like 12 more weeks and the racetrack's already going to be open again. So yeah, we're going to try to get as much of this stuff done as possible, guys. Cavalier, I want to get it ripping. And my black Mustang, I really want to get ripping. And then I have a Cutlass that I'm building too. So trying to build all these cars, get all these projects done, but you know, at the end of the day, a guy only has so much time. And with how busy I've been, you wonder why I've been drinking a lot of cold snacks when I get home. But anyways, I gotta run to the post office now. I'll probably be there for like a half hour because this stuff doesn't, you know, takes a little while because I gotta do customs forms for a couple of them because they're going to Canada. And, you know, doing that takes a little bit. And then they gotta go through and type it all in and, you know, whatever. And I got one of them fancy digital machines where you can just, I can weigh them and do my own postage just because I use these cheaper packages because it saves me money on packaging doing it this way. And I just take them to the post office and I just give them to the clerk and she rings them up. But it takes a little while to do it because, you know, I'm that jackass that shows up with a whole pile of fucking packages walking in and drop them all on the counter. Well, I just left the post office. I'm on my way home and I lost the tack. The lights are really dim on the dash, like really dim. It actually looks really bright on the camera, but I promise they're super dim. So I'm hoping I make it home. I think the alternator took a dump. And the car's starting to misfire and stuff, so she's probably got no voltage. Don't let me down now, DSM. You made it almost all day without braking. Yeah, it's spitting and sputtering. SRS lights on. This guy in front of me doesn't have headlights on. I'd flash him, but I'll just let him get pulled over instead. Where are you going there, buddy? You ain't got no headlights on. No headlights. Nothing. Niner. one more block. Get me home. Oh, just when I thought I had it all figured out. I made it home. Just barely. Let's see if my conclusion is right. Let's turn it off and see if it comes back on. Nothing. She dead her in the door now. So, we'll just add that to the list. I'll just take a real quick glance at this thing. Because I came out the other day and the battery was dead. And the brake lights, I came home the day before that and the brake lights were stuck on. So I adjusted the brake switch because if the brake switch was just pushed like ever so slightly, the brake lights would stay on. So I adjusted the brake switch so the lights turn off and the brake switch is adjusted properly now. But yeah, now the alternator. Now the belt's still on. We'll see if we got any juice coming out of the end there, the positive connection. What's the luck if we just blew a fuse or something? Or you think all the oil in the alternator? All the oil in that alternator is probably what did it. I don't know. Some guy in the last video was actually telling me this is the wrong dipstick, and I'm hoping he's right, because it doesn't fit that good. All right, back home. Kind of took a little break, watched basketball game for a little while, and yeah, alternator doesn't seem to be charging on the Talon. So I got home, barely made it home, and the car would not start back up. Alternator not charging. So I go to inspect under the hood, and funny, I didn't notice this yesterday, but I did notice some funky stuff down by the alternator here. You can see there's like two leads coming off of the positive post on the alternator, and the signal wire, or like the exciter wire plug, not plugged in at all. It's actually sitting right here. So this was never plugged in, and you can see that it's got like some burnt wire on it. This, like, at least that's kind of what it looks like. Maybe that one of the leads is burnt. Don't know exactly, but I went to go plug it back in, and I'm like, ah, maybe it just popped back out. So I plugged it in, and still nothing. So I inspected inside of here, and the pins were bent over. Like, you know, it got shoved in too hard or something. So I proceeded to straighten out the pins and plug it in. And when I plug it in, the belt starts to shred. Like it's loading the alternator way too much or something is going on. So this is a little suspicious because this is the second time that the battery has died on me. It's funny because I charged a battery last night and I must have made it all day long on just the battery. So Optima yellow top banana battery. Good job. So, and I notice it runs a lot better when it has proper voltage. And if I could just get this thing charging, I'm assuming that all this is going to be fixed. This car is going to run even better. But alternator, not charging. So that is an issue. I don't know why it was unplugged when I bought it, because it was like this ever since I got it, honestly, and I just never noticed until now. So alternator, I don't know what's going on with it. I might take the alternator off and have it go test it at the parts store or something to see if it's good. If it's bad, maybe I'll pick up a replacement and try to trace down the wiring of why it's doing the things it's doing. I don't know what it's doing. If anybody's a DSM expert down in the comments, feel free to let me know. I'm really curious on why this thing is not charging. I don't know why it's not charging. So anyway, I got home today. And now, the rest of the stuff on my list, it's like almost 10 o'clock now. But I would like to get the oil changed on this sled So we can go ride it tomorrow, and I'll be able to ride it a little harder without caring, knowing that I have new oil in it, because I don't think the oil's been changed since 2014. So 7 years old, it might be a little old. It might be a little watery. So I'd like to change the oil. But the problem is I can't run the thing in here because the exhaust comes out the back. So I have to like flip the snowmobile around, and the Talon's in here. So I was going to back up the Talon, move that truck back, move these all out of here, just to move that forward so I can idle it for 10 minutes. Just to warm up the oil before I drain it, because I never change oil on stuff unless the oil's warmed up. Doesn't really pay to drain the oil if it's all thick and cold, because you won't get all of it out. So yeah, I got this snowmobile all apart because I just wanted to check it over, top the oil. It's a two-stroke, so I just topped the oil tank off, inspected the belt and stuff, all looks mint. So this thing's ready to ride. Yeah, probably just patch this thing back up. And yeah, I don't know. Came home to relax, you know, kind of take my mind off of stuff. A little bit, had some, you know, got some stuff done today, but came home and have this alternator issue just really put me over the edge. And I was like, you know, fuck this, fuck today. I'm just gonna go sit and have some cold snacks. So I did, and here I am, a little bit clearer head, you could say. It's funny because, like, I don't know, it sucks. I don't know this year if I've been drinking more or what, but like I feel like when days just go to shit, a cold snack just really fucking helps take the edge off. You know, I don't know, pick your poison, I guess, but helps me. Anyways, so I gotta figure out this alternator situation. Probably just put it off for now. But I went inside, watched a basketball game for a little while with the girlfriend. Yeah, it was a good game. Nonetheless, the Bucks are killing it. They killed it tonight, at least. Doing really well. And yeah, so a guy goes inside to relax, and as I'm relaxing, I whip out my phone and I check out the old Facebook Marketplace, and lo and behold, I find this rust-free 99 Honda Civic for $2,500. And this is why I have a problem. Like, I literally have a problem, guys. Like, I have too much stuff going on, and then I go to relax and I'm like, ooh, what else can I fuck up my life with? And this is it right here. 99 Honda Civic. Like, clean AF. Like, this thing is mint. Like, super mint. So I'll probably go buy it tomorrow and, you know, use it as a daily, as you could say, even though I probably won't use it as a daily. I don't know what I'll use it for, but it is so clean. I can't pass it up for $2,500 OBO. And this guy has like super well detailed, you know, ad here. He's owned it for a long time. He took a YouTube video of it. He's got a good Carfax, shop receipts. Honestly, like, it's just a, like, I feel like I can't pass it up because it's a really well-kept car. It seems that way, at least. And it's really tough to find a clean Civic, especially during the COVID. I feel like Civics have just been flying off the market. But here we are in my garage with a DSM. I don't know. I would like a little gas guzzler, or I would like a little gas sipper. It'd be nice to have something that isn't so hard on the wallet. I normally just drive my Duramax all the time because diesel was cheaper than gasoline. And now diesel is like 70 cents more than gasoline. So it cost me like $80 to fill my Duramax, which still goes, you know, about 500 miles or so. But if I could fill up a Honda Civic for $15... and drive that the same amount of time, I don't know, it might be smarter, especially if I gotta do this drive to the shop every day. You know, gotta be smarter, gotta work smarter. Don't be stupid, right? So maybe, yeah, maybe we'll do that car. I don't know, you guys let me know what you think of that car. If you're local to Wisconsin and you see it on the marketplace, guy posted a YouTube video too, of how clean the car is and just kind of doing a walk around of it. If y'all want to check it out, it's on the Appleton Oshkosh Fond du Lac Craigslist as well. So if you guys want to go down there and check out the YouTube video I got posted, and let me know if I should buy it or not. I don't know. I'm kind of up in the air about it, but it seems like a really clean car, and maybe we can do a couple little modifications to it and bring her back around, even though it's already perfect. Yeah, let me know. Have a great night and a better tomorrow, guys. We'll see you later.